Blue skin. Death squid. Death squid. What is devour Vayne? It's taking smite on Vayne to get the devour item. That shit's garbage though. Dude, I don't think it's terrible, but nah, it's garbage. It's garbage. Yeah, I doubt it. Why is no one play Annie? The one shot potential so high on her? It's because she's actually pretty shitty. Like, you're so easily ganked and you can get 1v1 pretty easily. But this is so lucky, so I mean, yeah. We got the exhaust too. Up the juke though. If they don't shop off of that kill, I don't really give a shit. I think they might have gone to shop though. No, they didn't. Okay. Well, then that's whatever. I don't really give a shit if they get that kill then. As long as they don't shop off of the kill, then it's fine. The problem is when they actually get like an advantage. They're gonna hit level 2, yeah. Call me Rocky. Hey, buddy. Oh, pretty good. That's gonna give me a big ol' fucking lead. This lane gets really fucking hard for Callista Bliss. Cause if I'm not shit, I can just dodge, like, everything. And I'll damage Callista in straight up fights. Whatever. That's pretty good for us. Not bad. Do I ever max Q over W? It depends. Honestly, it depends how I feel. Like I don't do it for matchups or anything. It's just like, wow, I really feel like maxing Q today, and then I'll just max Q. Like, that's how I feel with like a lot of items too. It's not like for any reason. It's just, oh, I feel like doing this, so I'm gonna do it. Maybe there is a reason, but I can't like think of it. And my mind just tells me it's because I feel like it, but yeah. It's like very rare that I ever max Q. Because W is just so nice. The damage you get from W is so get nerfed. Yeah, Kalista got nerfed. I don't know how bad the nerf was. I don't think the nerf was that bad. But I haven't tried Kalista out myself, so I'll probably put in a Kalista game eventually. Cause I like playing Kalista. About Kalista a bunch. I keep wanting to out of the creep to rend it, but then I remember I'm not fucking Kalista. Where's my smite, dude? Fucked it to Devour Vayne, man. I gave up on that shit. I must have lost at least like 8 games as Devour, Kog'Maw, and Vayne. I think I lost like 8 of the 9 games that I played as it. So yeah, gotta retire that bad boy. Don't wanna drop out of Masters. Pow7703J, thank you for 2 months in a row resubscribing. God bless you and welcome back to the Big Dick Club, buddy. Appreciate the support a lot, dude. Thank you very much, my man. I don't hate Kalista. I just hate that she's the, like, I think she's pretty fun. I just hate that she's like the only viable one right now. Cause again, like, variety's the spice of, or, I mean, she's not the only viable one now, obviously, cause she got fucking nerfed, but variety's the spice of life, dude. I hate being stuck on one champion. Norton's Mortons, thank you for 2 months in a row resubscribing. God bless you and welcome back to the Big Dick Club, buddy. Appreciate the Tristana. Tristana's great. She's really good. She does a lot of damage. She has a good steroid. She's great late game. Yeah, Tristana's really good right now. I mean, I don't know. There's not much else to say about it. She's just really good right now. I personally think whenever Tristana's viable, that means there's some fucked up shit in the meta. That means the meta's real fucked up if Tristana's viable. Fuck, man. Okay. Fuck, man. I want that fucking experience. No. Oh, well. They just gotta take my terror. There's not much I can do there. Actually, I don't think I want Bleed Trinket. I think I'm just gonna upgrade for myself. What are the best ADCs in the current meta for solo queue? I think Vayne's really good. I think Tristana's okay. Sivir's probably the best. Yeah, I just go with those three. I'm sure I missed someone, but those are the three that I'd go with. Clements809, thank you for 8 months in a row resubscribing. God bless you and welcome back to the Big Dick Club, buddy. Appreciate it. Oh yeah, Corki's pretty good. Yeah, Corki's. Corki's nice. Jinx is like, the problem with Jinx is she's so team reliant. Like, you need your team behind her to really do work. I guess that was okay. Dude, I fucking hate targeting the stupid ass, I hate targeting the fucking turrets of Heimer. I don't know why, but it feels like I always mistarget them. I mean, I know why, because I do mistarget them. What I think are the strengths and weaknesses of Ashe. Her strength is she has an error. Her weakness is that everything. She just gets killed by everything. You can't play Ashe versus tanks. Like, Ashe was like a tank destroyer in the old meta because tanks aren't like how they are now. Like, you're not getting away. I mean, you could get away with playing against a tank in this meta. Fuck, man. Jesus. He's probably gonna look for me again, so I have to walk all the way around. No, you aren't. Holy fuck. Oh my god, fuck me, dude. Fuck. I got wrecked by her ass. I should have healed. I probably could have double killed them. I was expecting to kill her so quickly. But yeah, nah. I didn't do that much damage. Not yet, at least. Not yet, at least. Hi, Lee. Thank you for 6 months in a row resubscribing. God bless you, and welcome back to the Big Dick Club, buddy. Appreciate the support a lot, dude. Thank you very much, my man. Boom. I hear the innocent boom. Yeah, I should have healed, and I should have probably pinged, because if I had Lulu's shit, I wouldn't need to waste my heal. I really didn't want to waste my heal there. Oh my god, fuck me, dude. Alright, you went a very dangerous way, my friend. That is a, I don't know about going that way. That's a very questionable path to take. Would have opted for the other route, but... Hippie Dennis, thank you for 5 months in a row resubscribing. God bless you and welcome back to the Big Dick Club, buddy. Appreciate the support a lot, dude. Thank you very much, my man. Wow, that killed him. What the fuck? Holy shit. He keeps taking the fucking ADC spot. I love it. He's just going through the band. Holy fuck. I got fucking wrecked by that thing. I'm gonna get farm top. I killed him with that. Nice. Okay. We're probably good to take a team fight now. I don't think they have any. Okay, he just split potion. Guys, fucking lived is like two fucking life. Feels bad, man. He's probably not gonna get any of these. Oh! He's probably away. Oh, I fucking micro'd that so shitty. I'm just gonna get shot. Fuck. At least somehow got the dragon too. I love it. Ah, fuck me, dude. I don't have fucking ulti for this shit. This is such a bad fight. Like, unless we have a pink, we can't spot out the, whatever fuck his name is for me, there's no point in taking the team fight, because I have to. I think the guy just crashed into a wall. Oh, that was a sick combo. I think the Sion ulted the wall. I don't know what kind of angle he could have taken to end up where he ended up. Like the angle of collision that he had was like, he had to either ult into here to end up where he was, or he just ulted straight into the fucking wall. I like it, dude. Good stuff. Good stuff. Yeah, the beauty of playing ADC is because it's like, it's a role where you have to pay attention to everything in team fights. You get to see everyone's fuck ups. That's the beauty of it. So when you see your Sion ulti straight into a fucking wall, it's like, alright, my tank's a fucking idiot. My tank's a fucking goon. Okay, let me get Bloodthirster. Bloodthirster will make it, so I mean, I'm still gonna insta die no matter what, but this at least gives me like an extra like second before I get insta killed, so it's not bad. Do I ever build attack speed first? No, I'd never build the recurve bow first. I always go for just damage. The thing is, the damage helps a lot more in lane than the attack speed, because it doesn't matter if you have a million attack speed if you're doing one damage in auto. At least that's how I look at it. I mean, who knows? Maybe building recurve is better first, but that's the beauty, dude. This is what solo queue has taught me, is that the blue trinket is fucking useless. If you're versus Rengar as an ADC, you should always buy this fucking pink trinket. Because the only person you can rely on, look at this shit. I have two other people with pink trinket and one guy with Oracle Lens, and none of them fucking used it. Fucking worthless ass motherfuckers. Nah, I'm just playing, I love these guys, but yeah, at the end of the day, the only person you can rely on is yourself, so like, it's best to just get the pink trinket versus Rengar so you can just spot him yourself. Because the thing is, if Rengar can't actually, like, get the jump on you, like, if he can't stealth your ass, then he's not as effective.